next game is Falcons Rams. And that will be the Falcons.
Today, from Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, Georgia, this is Madden NFL 21 on EA Sports.
First opened in 2017, there's a look at the beautiful state-of-the-art Mercedes-Benz Stadium here in Atlanta, GA. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Los Angeles Rams and the Atlanta Falcons.
Jeez,
and good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20.
At their own 19-yard
line. Just realized Todd Gurley against
the first and 10 now down inside the 20. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. Throwing on second and 8.
First down.
Got his man. That's the Pro Bowler Julio Jones.
First down.
He had to figure they'd try and get the ball to Julio early, and they did it right there. And it doesn't
play
take a degree
cheesy.
From MIT
really
to
is.
Know that, so you had to figure, what's up with the defense? You
should
know
Aaron
that's
Donald.
Coming right away.
That's Aaron Donald.
And
in the face.
Away this time as they're going to stop it right around the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play. Second and 10. At the 36.
Second down, Ryan. Mm-hmm. It's complete. This is Todd Gurley.
Is that a touchdown? Come on. There we go. Wow. 64 yards. That's a big way to open the game.
And the Falcons have taken the early lead.
Lining up for the point after.
Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it too before making the run. Heck of a play for the
score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a Darren Cousy complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
For the Falcons.
Now following the touchdown, Hoff Richter to kick off. This will make it into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Golf will lead the Rams up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Defense holds up.
They'll run for the first time here with Brown. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
It's a gain of 7.
Successful toss play to the right there. It's interesting, teams seem to run the toss a lot more to the right than to the left.
It's usually a little more natural. Right-handed quarterback, typically the power side running the ball.
I need to stop switching to people midway and let them handle
the tackle. In college football, they used to call it student body right, because you had everyone on that side, including a fullback, leading. In the pros, they don't call it that, but it's still the same result.
Goff fakes the give to
Richard.
He'll throw. Oh, a scram for the football, and he's going to come down with it. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done.
It's a gain of 20.
Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
All right. They're marching. It's not good. This defense is not going to be helping me at all. Come here. Richard. I should have sacked him.
As he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
He certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Back to the air. Goff on second down. He'll get this one to Kopp complete.
First down.
Going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 15-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. This will be caught just inside.
See, I said I was going to stop doing that, and then I didn't do it.
End zone, touchdown, Rams. touchdown. The connection there, Goff to Cooper Kupp. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Personally, for him, a great opening drive. He had three catches, including the touchdown.
That felt like tremendous scouting, great film watching, and creating a game plan to start this off, not only to get him involved, but to send a message to the defense. You got a lot to handle in this one.
And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
First and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
17-yard line.
On second and 12, Ryan toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. And the tight end, Luke Stocker, was the target. And it's third down.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think
you
were actually fortunate.
Well upfield, right around the 40-yard line. Called that a very strong gain of 24.
I can't remember, is it Julio or Julio Jones?
Now a draw play for Gurley.
Bang
he'll
it.
Be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. These two teams all tied after one.
Tied 7-7.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. On the stop was Aaron Donald. This game circled on the calendar for Todd Gurley as he gets a chance to run against the team he spent his first five NFL seasons with. He was a first-round pick back when they were still the St. Louis Rams in 2015, and he went on to rush for better than 5,400 yards with 70 total touchdowns for them. Give him 14 on that one.
All right, Aaron Donald's there on the left, so that's not going to go there.
Here's first and 10.
Bingo.
Smash him.
Shit.
A 14-yard pickup. That's 14 yards on two straight plays.
Good first down.
14 more yards.
There's a run there by Todd Gurley. We all know he's looking to rebound from the least productive season of his career. And I think Atlanta presents him a great opportunity to do just that.
Good.
Use him really well running it, as well as catching it out of the backfield.
A full 5-yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough. On second and 15 now.
That's...
And this is incomplete. Intended target on that one, Russell Gage. And that'll make it third down. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper levels.
Let's go.
We'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Falcons have taken the lead. Well, he has two hands. He only needed one there. What an excellent grab.
How about those mitts, huh?
Good job. Defense got to put up a stop.
I thought he really doesn't need two hands to catch the ball. He just showed us exactly that.
Hoffrichter to kick off for the
now following the touchdown, Hoffrichter to kick off. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Well, let's talk about, Charles, the Rams' start to the season before this next drive gets going. They're 2-0, had the opening week win against the Cowboys Sunday night, followed it up with a strong win against Philadelphia, and that was a matchup of the number one and number two picks of the 2015 draft, and Jared Goff got the upper hand on Carson Wentz, throwing three touchdown passes, all to Tyler Higbee.
Yeah, and he looked really, really good. I mean, for all the issues that Jared Goff went through last year, I feel like a number of them have been corrected this year, and the Rams have made an adjustment. And Tyler Higbee, their tight end, he started to emerge about the last month of last season, and he's just continued with that hot streak. He's one of the better tight ends in the league. So you look at this Rams team, plenty of turnovers in Super Bowl 53, but it looks like this team's starting to gel right now. Big road win in Philadelphia. Now they've got three of their next four away from home in L.A. They go to Buffalo and take on the 2-0 Bills. What a matchup that's going to be. Jared Goff and Josh Allen, the quarterback of the Bills.
He'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Give me a blitz
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
No, he's just going to throw it. Nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert.
Ringo.
Out of the backfield, he's got Malcolm Brown. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that will hit
pass
in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. At their own, Matt Ryan and the Falcon offense set to get going again. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your
confidence. How is that not pass interference?
It's a lead, and they feel really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fill him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover. The angle route, because a running back.
That's really cool.
Jones, and it's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked up.
That's what I get for being a dumbass.
To the 37-yard line.
I literally stared at him as I threw it.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
There we go. Pick it up.
Here he lost the football. And the Falcons grab it. And his guys are going to take over at their own 38-yard line. Every week we hear talk about create turnovers. In particular, they wanted to force some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed over time. It used to be good enough for a guy to get a sack and the quarterback in the pocket. Now, your coaches are upset with you. All right, so if you're a quarterback, it starts all the way back in the youth leagues. Take care of the ball, because here come the defenders.
Bingo.
He's got a star receiver.
That's what we
Jones. The Falcon touchdown.
We just erased those two turnover plays back to back.
Jones. 30 yards. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. The PAT up and good, but hold on a second. There is a flag. So that one will be accepted.
Sterling Hoffrichter to kick off for the Falcons.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Getting set to go again here, Robert Woods marches back onto the field. You better believe that he's well aware he has zero catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited that he has no catches, but they're also worried, because a lot of times, that's like the ticking time bomb. The longer you hold him down, when he finally explodes, look out.
Yeah, no catches, though, so far this game. Side is Brown. Touchdown. LA.
Pass complete.
Malcolm Brown. 59 yard.
You. What are you doing? 27. Where's the zoom button? Where's Mr. There it is. Cassie, I don't give a shit what your name is. What the hell are you doing? Did you not hear a word I just said?
For 6 points.
I said let's keep him out of the end zone, and then you just glitch and let him go.
It's up and good. This becomes a
13-second drive because the dude didn't know what he was doing.
On their own 25, two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. Here's Powell on the return. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Take over first and 10.
About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line.
What?
First down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Well, CD, unfortunately, some somber news across the league in week two coming from New England Patriots running back James White, because his parents were in a car crash, and his father, Tyrone, captain of the Miami-Dade Police Department, passed away in that accident, and his mother, Lisa, also sustained critical injuries. So it was obviously a tough one. James White did not play in the game on Sunday, but we did see the outpouring of support from around the National Football League and how this really is one big family.
Yeah, he was really embraced, as you mentioned, by the National Football League. We saw social posts from plenty of players around the league, including Tom Brady, former teammate of his with the New England Patriots. We saw an outpouring in terms of, you know, other guys.
Please get back, get back, get back, get back.
Played with him in college at Wisconsin. And not only that, how about his own teammates? Devin McCourty scored a touchdown against Seattle and ran up and told the camera, "Hey, 2-8, we're thinking about you, we love you." And the rest of the guys chimed in from there. And the Patriots organization offered to fly him home on the private jet.
Max,
he stayed with his team, stayed in their embrace, and now he has to go and face the difficult task of saying goodbye to his dad and tending to his mom. But he's got plenty of support from around the league, from the Patriots, and of course his own family.
L.A. set to take over again on offense. Goff will lead the Rams up here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He starts the drive by handing it to Brown. Brown with a stick skills, and he'll be out right at the 35. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down.
At the 35-yard line.
Right back to Brown. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Now that's the way to do it.
Hand it to
someone
boys.
With vision and good footwork and handling a little bit of power.
This is why I wanted to stop
at the
end of the last
time. They'll run on first down.
And they stop means you stop playing. 27, looking for you wherever you are.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay.
Can't
I can stand
any
up when the going gets tough in here.
9 yards to pick up there.
Doing everything
the
game
down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. That catch good for only a couple.
It's second and
so
eight.
Second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
Bingo!
And the Falcons get there.
I don't know how that happened.
Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Grady Jarrett able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's what a first down marker is here on third. A shotgun snap for Goff. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out into open space. The linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of six.
The ball carrier.
The last run got six. Now second and four. Again they run with Gurley. And he'll get it to the 33-yard line.
Good.
And at least 3 points.
And there's a catch by Todd Gurley, and that has to remind us that's exactly what we've seen in him throughout his career when he's at his best. He can run it, he can catch it. He led the league in total yards from scrimmage in 2017 with nearly 3,000. Todd
they
Gurley,
can't stop
when he's on point, is quite a weapon for the Atlanta Falcons.
And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one.
He's brought down at the
heavy set out there on third and one. Back now in Atlanta. It's the Falcons. They've got the football. They've got the lead as we get set to start the fourth. They'll try and pick up the first with Gurley. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
First down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
8 yards on the pickup, brings up second and
now on second down, this is Gurley.
Pretty good workload right now.
To a first down at the Rams 36. That one a first down pickup of 8.
Field goal range.
So the heels of the run by Todd Gurley. Another first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. He's able to force his way through one man, but he can muster only about a yard on the play. Second down.
Gain of a yard. Brings up second.
Now they'll throw it with Ryan.
Cool.
You want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched.
Nice. Freaking dumbass, dude.
They need it. It's intercepted.
And he's going to...
Troy Hill picks it. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there.
God.
And he will bring it back. Touchdown. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown.
Fuck me, dude.
Third down, passing down. They throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have five defensive backs on the field and an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here.
Been laughed at by the commentators.
The kicks away. Ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They will look to flush the memory of that pick six as we now have a brand new tie ball game here in the fourth quarter. Getting down to the good stuff. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. And the ball on the 30 here, second and 4.
Just gained 2 yards.
Slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. This is third and 2. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And they're facing a big third down now.
No!
And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down.
I hate this game.
Pass knocked away and incomplete. Dan Quinn's guys unable to come through.
I'm pulling a Falcons right now, dude.
And the Rams get the football in outstanding field position. On first down, Brown wiggles free.
What?
Out of bounds inside the 30. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
A gain of 5 brings up second and 5.
Keep it on the ground and
get over
now. Down to the 25.
The ball carrier.
Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. They'll run on third down.
God!
First down at about the 21-yard line. They have the first down with that gain of 4.
I mean, yeah, shit, what the
first down, Los Angeles.
They'll run on first down. It's Brown. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Brings up second and 8 at the 20-yard line.
On second down. It's Brown. Another 2 yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's 3rd and 6. Now a timeout called for by the defense as they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Shotgun handoff to Brown here. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
For the Rams field goal.
They bring the blitz, and it's not always the initial blitzers that make the play. In this case, the blitzers actually took up the blocking. How about the guy in the middle, though? Reading his keys right on the spot, stops him at the line of scrimmage.
Hoped to all right, so time to reset here. It's a Falcons huge fans enjoy a win, lead, but then I decided to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
So Ryan and the Falcons down 24-21, 20 seconds to go. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
What a load of shit. I didn't do the no huddle, but
going into the final play of this game, they knew that
they didn't go to no huddle. I don't know. I hate this game.
At the very end, they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
We'll be right back.